Hey guys, I have another Yinyasa practice for you today. It's really one of my favorite ways to practice because you hit the best of both worlds. Yin, where we are trying to be more passive and just get a deeper stretch, and then Vinyasa, which is moving and more active. I'm gonna keep this one a little bit on the shorter side for those of you that have requested some shorter classes to just fit those days where you have a little bit of extra other things going on. We're gonna start on hands and knees with a little cat-cow. Inhale, tuck the toes, drop the belly, chest forward. Exhale, flatten the feet and round up. All right, doing a few rounds here. And as needed, any other types of wiggling to your cat-cow routine that you like, of course, go for that. Little side-to-side movement, shoulder rolling, etc. Wrist stretching, weight shifting. One more round. Okay, from here, I'm gonna come into a hovering table, right? Making sure that I've got a proper distance between hands and knees, right? Neutral spine, right? Hovering the knees on an inhale, I'm gonna lift a down dog. Exhale, come back to that hovering table, right? Waking up the core and the arms a little bit. And then next time in down dog, I'll pause there and wiggle that out. Pedaling the feet. Maybe a little side to side with the hips. All right, and from a more static down dog, let's take the right leg up toward the ceiling, trying to keep the hips square to start and everything else the same. And then we'll work to open the hips toward the right. And then square back down. Let's try that just a couple times, bringing some awareness to the hips. And then we'll step that foot forward and find warrior one, back foot a little forward into the left, 45 degree angle. We'll reach up the arms, and then we'll work some side body action here, reaching up a little higher from side to side. I like to call this one the slinky. One more each side. Okay, from here, I'm gonna lift the back heel, weight shifts forward, arms go back. And then heel back down, arms back up, warrior one. A few times there. Inhale, exhale, let's do one more. Okay, from this forward position, get really light on those back toes and try lifting the leg, front knee still bent. So warrior three-ish, but bent knee and a little bit higher up with the torso. And then we'll bring the back leg forward and try figure four, crossing ankle above the knee. Let's try that warrior three-ish position again. We'll get the toes back down and the heel back down, back to warrior one. Exhale, hands to the mat. Step into plank, inhale. On toes or knees down, exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Okay, we'll take the left leg up. Try to be square for a moment, and then open. Close the door, open the door. One more time. And we'll step it forward, warrior one. Back foot over to the right a little bit and forward.
are slinky, reaching up higher from side to side. All right, and from here, back heel lifts, arms back, weight forward, and then back to warrior one. Breathing. Okay, and from that forward position, get lighter on those back toes. Feel those glutes work on the left leg. Float that right leg up. Breathe. Draw it forward, lifting a little higher, crossing over for figure four. Flex that right foot. Okay, let's find our previous position. Toes come down, heel down, back to warrior one. Exhale, hands down. Take it into plank. Inhale. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale. Up dog. Exhale, down dog. Okay, so we're gonna do a little bit of that leg work again from down dog. Right, we're gonna go to the open position and do some leg scissoring to feel some side body work and a little bit of hip and glute work. So we'll take the right leg up. And then we'll open the hip and we'll take the leg higher and lower, back and forth a few times, like a scissor action. And then we'll square it again, bring it forward, step it through, warrior two, back foot about parallel to the back of the mat. Reaching forward for extended side angle. Maybe the right forearm on the thigh, left arm right beside your ear. Then we're gonna do some movement with that top arm, work the shoulder a little bit, pulling down to cactus shape. Inhale, reaching over. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, from this cactus position, let's extend the arm toward the back of the mat. Internally rotate the shoulder, thumb down, palm back. And we'll bend that elbow and take the hand behind the back. If you want to just rest it there, if you want to maybe bind a little bit more, if you have a long arm, maybe grab your right thigh. And then we'll straighten the leg and maybe reach a little lower for a half-bound triangle. And then just look straight ahead and let your right ear kind of drop down for a neck stretch. Arm up. And we'll take the hands down and set up swan, which is like pigeon. Right knee over to the right. Left leg stays on the left. All right, I'm going to go into sleeping swan, which is the folded version. You can stay upright. You can also do a version of this pose on your back, right? If your knees feel a little bit squirrely here, find that figure four cross that we did in our balance pose a little while ago and do that lying down. And that might feel just a little bit friendlier if this one feels like it's too much. And we'll chill out here for a couple of minutes. And you could use blocks, blankets, bolsters, propping up either hip, your head, your abdomen, right? Feel free to experiment with what you've got at home. A few pillows work too.
Sometimes I like to just kind of turn my head side to side to give the forehead a massage, and you can put the block in some different spots on your head to hit some different areas.
Other variations that you can try here from your swan position, just like you might doing this pose pigeon style in a regular, more active yoga class. Like I said before, maybe you stay upright, maybe you want to do a little back leg work by reaching for your back foot, right? Wherever you feel like it's going to serve you best. We'll take just a couple more breaths here. Okay. And you can always just go right into down dog. If you're feeling like you need a little bit of movement, you can step into plank. Inhale. Exhale. Chaturanga. Inhale. Up dog. Exhale. Down dog. Okay, we'll take the left leg up, we'll let it open, and then we'll try higher and lower with that leg, and just until we feel some side body, side hip action. And we'll square it again, then bring it forward and step it through, warrior two. Lifting up. And reaching forward for extended side angle. Maybe forearm on the thigh. Right over the ear, chest up. And we'll exhale. Pull that top arm back to cactus shape. Inhale, reach it back overhead. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale from here. We'll stay in that cactus shape, feeling open. Extend back. Rotate. Hand behind the back, lightly, or if you want to kind of reach around and find more of a bind, go for it. Straightening into a triangle shape. And then letting your ear drop to stretch your neck. Arm up, take the hands down, we'll transition to swan, sleeping or otherwise, knee over to the left, right leg scoots back and stays on the right, right, remember you have the reclined version available, that figure four cross, but lying down, prop it up as desired for comfort, and we'll chill out here for a little bit. Breathing, scanning, and noticing anywhere that you might be hanging on, gripping. Let's see if you can let your breath help you to relax a little bit more, soften. Check your shoulders, your neck. You did a little bit of head movement on the first side. Maybe you turned your head to one side and hold there for a little bit of time to give a little bit more of a neck stretch. Right, a little bit of time on both sides. I'm going to
to switch to the other side, turning my head to the right.
To come back upright, or if you want upright for a bit, maybe you fold, maybe you try that back leg, foot grab, or a little bit more quad, hip flexor stretch on the back leg. Let's take a couple more breaths here. You could just go right to down dog from here if you're feeling more toward the yin than the yang today. If you feel like you need a little bit of movement, we can take it in plank. Inhale, exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog, exhale, down dog.
Okay, from here, let's revisit something from the very beginning where we went from down dog to a table hover.
Right, letting weight shift forward, hovering the knees, trying to keep the spine neutral. And then from here, last time, hover, take your knees down. All right, we'll lift up to kneeling, arms reach up, send the tailbone down, and then we'll take right arm down and do a little, like a twisty one-arm camel to the right. Come back up, twisty one-arm camel to the left, and back up. And I'm gonna take both hands to my lower back. You can reach for heels if you like. We'll hang out in a full camel for just a little bit. This is also a yin pose. It's not one that I hold as long as some of the others. All right, make sure you're breathing. Here, tuck the toes under, see if we can sit on the heels for a toe squat to give the feet a stretch. Also a yin pose that I don't hold as long as some of the other ones. Toe squat, I'm going to come into regular squat. Right, move the heels down and the feet a little wider. Right, and you could always prop your heels up on a blanket. You can sit on a block or a bolster. Right, make sure that you're feeling supported. Yet another yin pose. Maybe we don't hold quite as long, or we don't enjoy for quite as long as we do things like swan, etc. Transition back to knees down for saddle. Feet are flat. If your ankles need support, maybe a blanket, right? You can prop your hips up on pillows, blocks, etc. Right? Knees can widen if that feels better. You could do just one leg at a time, right? stretch through the legs. Right, if you want to recline a little bit, sometimes that feels nice and gives you some multitasking. I like to use a block for help with that, so I get a little chest opening out of it. So you can give that a go. Bolsters work great too. Make sure that you're propped enough to feel like your knees are still safe. Chill out here for a little bit. Just your breathing. It's always a good sign if you have chosen an appropriate position to be in, right? If you have trouble breathing and have trouble just kind of settling, maybe you've gone a little too far. Let's try a couple more deep breaths here. Careful as you come up, tuck your chin. If you're all the way down, use your hands to help you lift back up. And from here, we'll come to our seat just to transition and give the legs a little wiggle out in front of us. Okay. Last set of hand poses, lying down. Great, so we'll come on down and you can choose your favorite spinal twist variation. I'm just going to do both knees dropping over to one side, right? And you can take arms out. Maybe the hand that's closest to your legs is resting there. Right, head can turn in either direction. As you're holding here and breathing, just kind of focus on the side of your body, right? If your knees are over to the left, focus on the right side body area, thinking of trying to get a little bit more length and space, right? So that your hip is moving off of your waist, right? There's more space underneath the rib cage there on your side. Take that over to the other side. Right, make sure that you adjust to get comfortable. Right, shoulders more relaxed. Again, just breathing and getting in touch with how things feel on your left side body area, right? Making space between the top of the hip and the bottom of your rib cage there on that side, space for your waist.
take a couple more breaths here. Come up out of that twist and get set up for Shavasana. Right, feel free to prop a bolster, blankets, blocks under your knees, pillows can work too. We'll get set up. Right, scanning to make sure we have space for the neck and the shoulders. Relaxing your jaw and your face. Just letting go of your breath, letting it return to a natural state, and giving yourself these last few moments just to rest. Start to deepen the breath again. Invite some gentle movement into fingers and toes and wrists and ankles. And reach your arms overhead, give yourself a long stretch. Give your knees a hug and rock side to side. To your side and rest there. And gently press up to seated. Bring your hands together at your heart, close your eyes. Take a moment to reflect and observe. Notice how the breath feels, how your body's feeling. Thank you so much for joining me for this Yinyasa practice. I look forward to practicing with you again soon. Namaste.